I wanted to start off with a dosa bandi and today I'm doing this. So the intent to get into the food business has been there for a very long time. It's just that sometimes you need to have find the right team, you need to have the right time, and you need to have the right experience to get into business. And all of this happened in a jiffy, you know. We never thought
Right place,
we'd,
right time.
yeah, right place, right time. See, I think that is the most important thing to start anything. Of course, your determination has to be there to start, but I think team is a very crucial link for a successful business and a not so successful one.
Hello everyone and welcome to Mentally Matcha. Today I have Harish Raghavendra with me. He is the owner and co-founder of Good Vibes Only Cafe here in Kajaguda. Hi Harish, how's it
Hey
going?
Shivani, how are you? I'm doing very well, and thank you so much for inviting me to this podcast, Mentami
Yeah.
Macha. And it's been, whirlwind last 1 month since we opened, and it's been, crazy.
Yeah, and it's only been a month that you guys have started,
Yeah,
right?
we opened on October 25th, so technically around 35-40 days, but the work that we put in to this place was last December. So technically I've been working since the last 1 year. So the place opened only on the 25th of October. So that is that's the amount of effort that one puts in to start a cafe, to start any business basically, because the effort is always unseen until it is successful, right?
Yeah. So you are very on brand when it comes to Good Vibes Only Cafe, because I remember the first time I came to the cafe, right while I was done, I asked the waiter, like, can I talk to the owner of the cafe? Because, you know, I was interested in talking to you. And honestly, he said, yeah, he's downstairs. And I'm like, okay, I'll come down and I'll meet. And I was a little scared to approach you because I'm like, oh, I don't know, like, it's maybe he's. I mean, I don't know, I was pretty scared to approach you. And then you came up and you spoke to me and you were so chill. And I'm like, wow, he's so down to earth. Like, I did not expect that, honestly. And yeah, that's why, like, when I
See,
look at you, I can think of good vibes.
fair enough. See, the thing is, I'm a first-time business owner. So, and we are in the hospitality industry. See, Good Vibes Only is a cafe, right?
Yeah.
So, any cafe which has to be successful, which has to have a longer run in the market, has to have a very close connect to its customer.
Yeah.
So, for that, me being the founder, if I'm not here, and if I'm not able to talk to my customers, understand their grievances, understand what they want, if there is some things that need to change in the menu or things that need to change in the drinks, beverages. So, me as the owner, I have the decision-making power to do it immediately.
Yeah,
So,
yeah.
if somebody else comes and talks to you, maybe they'll not be able to give the same vibe that the owner gives.
Yeah.
So that way, having a close connect to my customer is essential for any business today. Anything that is customer facing, if we are not open to meeting our customers, if we are not open to conversing with them, understanding them, and see, we are all good vibes. I mean, we are called Good Vibes Only Cafe for a reason, right? We want to give out positivity. We want to give out positive energies, positive vibrations. So that way, people also feel good when they come here. The feel-good factor has to be there. Otherwise, a client or a customer or a guest wouldn't want to come back again and again
Yeah,
unless they get that good vibe. So
true.
that has been the, you know, often, yeah, people do sometimes get intimidated when they see me, but once I start talking to them, they're like,
No, I mean, I didn't even see you, but I knew that, you know, your partners are Rashmika Mandanna and Deepak Kunda and all of them. So I'm like, oh, maybe he's like, it's always a little, you know, intimidating to meet celebrities and all of them.
See, the thing with celebrities is, for me, they're friends first and foremost. Anand has been a dear friend. Vijay has been a dear friend. We have literally grown up together. So from that perspective, the inclination of them being a celebrity doesn't rub off on me. For me, they're just my friends. I hang out with them. have fun with them, I chill with them, I travel with them.
Yeah.
So that way, I don't feel intimidated. And all of these guys, they're all come from the bottom up.
Mm-hmm.
So it is not like they have some godfather or somebody behind them who's sort of running the show and then they're just the actors. No.
Yeah.
They do everything themselves.
Mm.
So they have come from bottom up to where they are today through sheer hard work, through sheer grit. So that way we all get inspired from them to be, you know, the one of the main reasons for me to start this also, I was inspired from them.
How like, so?
Because of their hard work, their determination. See, mm-hmm. you have to be very determined to do what you want to do. If you are not determined,
mm-hmm.
you can get 100 great ideas. Ideas are easy, man. Ideas are easy to think of.
Yeah.
But ideas are very hard to execute.
Mm-hmm.
So if one does not have the focus, one does not have the grit to sort of stick to that idea.
Mm-hmm.
Other people might tell it's not a great idea, it will not work. Many people will only create hurdles. But if you are convinced of your conviction, of your intuition that yes, this is a brilliant idea and it will work out for sure, and you work towards it. So from that perspective, if you look at it, if you do that, success will come sooner or later. So for us, it has come pretty, I mean, we're not successful yet. We are just a 1 month old brand.
But you're already so pretty well known. For a 1 month old mm-hmm. brand cafe, the fact that 11,000 people came last weekend mm-hmm. to your cafe.
1100.
Oh, shit.
You missed a zero.
I'm like, yeah, I over exaggerate. Yeah,
1100 people came to the cafe. It was because of the marketing that our partners did.
Yeah, yeah.
So from that perspective, we have created that buzz.
Mm.
See, any new brand needs to create that buzz.
Mm.
So, and luckily we have got people who have created that buzz for us, and it is now for the team of Good Vibes only to give out the best product, the best service, the best consistency.
Yeah.
And in all of this, maintaining that vibe, because a cafe like this cannot become too robotic, right? There has to be a chill factor. There has to be, you know, you come in, you play a few games, you play carom board, you play chess, you have breakfast, you have, you know, multiple things that can be done here. You can work here, you can work from home, you can do podcasts, you can do, you know, all kinds of, you know, interesting things. This is a community, right? So our main motto is cafe, coffee and community.
Yeah.
So we have built the cafe, we have the coffee. Now we are in the
pretty good coffee.
Yeah, pretty good coffee. And we are in the process of building that community, because community is what will stay with you, good times or bad times, just like friends. Friends will stay with you, good times or bad times.
So what is different about Good Vibes Only?
See, basically, Good Vibes Only, I'll tell you the main motto behind Good Vibes. Why did I start Good Vibes?
Mm.
See, 2020 has been a bad year for everybody. There's Corona pandemic, there is n number of things that
almost
could have
World War III,
n number of things that could have gone wrong went wrong.
Mm.
But we as a human race stood by it, listened to the powers that be to stay at home, to keep ourselves safe. Of course we have done that, but the main agenda was, there have been a lot of negativity in the marketplace, in the economy, in people's lives, in
mm-hmm.
personal lives, husband and wives getting locked up in different places.
Yeah.
So all of that is a very painful thing. It's not easy as humans who are socially connected to be suddenly so disconnected,
mm-hmm.
you know, not even being able to go out of the room. So this negativity was very disheartening for me to see. And I thought, okay, what can we do? See, I wanted to always get into the cafe business, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we wanted to spread good vibes.
Mm-hmm.
So anybody who comes into this place has to get a good vibe, has to get a good feeling, has to get a good feeling about the place, about themselves, about the music, about the surroundings. So that way, at least whenever they are there in my cafe, they have that peace of mind, right? They feel, okay, good, this is a good place to come, have fun. So that was one of the reasons. And apart from that, Good Vibes Only being located in Khajaguda. Khajaguda, I've been coming to Khajaguda for the last 10 years now. Before that, it was just a small 10 feet road. Today, it's a 150 feet concrete road. And the amount of people that surround us, they're all mostly working from home. And they're all IT company, people who work in the IT companies and people who work for the movies. So we thought this is a good market to cater to, and there is no other place here that we can that can cater to that kind of a public.
Yeah.
So from that perspective, we put good vibes only. And see, I wanted to start off with a dosa bandi, and today I'm doing this.
Okay.
The intent to get into the food business has been there for a very long time. It's just that sometimes you need to find the right team, you need to have the right time, and you need to have the right experience to get into business. So from that perspective, that made me sort of, the time had come. And all of this happened in a jiffy, you know, we never thought.
Right place, right time.
See, I think that is the most important thing to start anything. Of course, your determination has to be there to start. But I think team is a very crucial link for a successful business and a not so successful one. So for me, our team is something which is very paramount for me to, you know, be successful, because one guy cannot do everything. So generally that goes for a toss. Whenever one guy does a lot of things, that doesn't end up too well. So that was very crucial for us.
I think also if you have a team, instead of just one person doing it, with a collective team, you dream bigger, is what I've noticed.
I think that is, you're absolutely right from that perspective.
Because people come in with their own ideas, and like, let's say I'm doing the podcast, I'm alone, but I really, really want a team, because one, it would make me accountable for the team, and two, the ideas that they pitch in, I think it will take me to a bigger, bigger
Your
audience.
Perspective changes.
Yeah, exactly.
Right? When you have 10 people thinking in 10 different ways. So not all the ways could be right, but 10 different perspectives are always more interesting, always more informative than just having one way of view. So your growth, your path, and the way you want to move ahead is always has a wider reach or a wider thought process. From the when 10 people put their heads together, it is always more information is there at hand to make that decision. But at the end of the day, your intuition has to be very strong. So you cannot, now let us say out of 10 people, 3 people tell you to go left, 3 people tell you to go right, 3 people tell you to go the straight way. You have to make that decision as the founder or the co-founder, which decision needs to be taken. So for that, intuition is very strong. See, for me, I always believe intuition is a hallmark for my way of thinking. Of course, I have traveled the world, I have had myriad experiences. For my intuition or my inner core, whatever it says, to be strong. So I listen to my intuition, I listen to my alter ego, right? So there is always two people. There is one in the front, and then that there is one inside that tells you, that veers you to that decision. So from that perspective, intuition for me is a very strong sort of a feel or an emotion to listen to. Many people, they don't listen to their intuition.
How do you practice listening to your intuition? What do you know what an intuition sounds like?
See, it's very simple. Let me tell you, it might be a very base example, but now let us say you're going out drinking with your friends. You've had the fourth peg. Your body from inside tells you, okay man, stop it. Don't go more than this. You chose to do it or not is your thing. But there are certain things, you know, when I came here, I felt, okay, this place has huge potential to do great things, to be our launch vehicle for our brand. So my inner core told me that. But my outer self was scared, like, where are you going to get the money from? Where is the team? What is the name of the brand? What are you going to serve? What will be the interiors of the cafe? That is the outer self talking. But the inner self knows that, okay, if you do something here, it is going to be successful. So the other five factors, other five or 10 or many factors, they put a hindrance to your inner thinking, right? You want to do something where you, which you're passionate about, but the outer circumstances don't allow you to. So that intuition has to be very strong in terms of a decision making. So you have to trust yourself in the first place,
mm-hmm.
very strongly, ki what I'm doing is right. And then you convince other people to sort of tell, okay, I think I'm right. You listen to me. Let us do it. If it is successful, everybody has the fruits of that success. So that is for me. Intuition plays a very strong role in my decision making or in my day-to-day life as well.
I think this is very similar to what Mel Robbins, I don't know if you know her, but she's a motivational speaker.
Mm-hmm.
In one of her videos, she talks about how to make the right decision and listening to your intuition.
Mm-hmm.
It's like if you're in two minds, think about how your body reacts to each situation. So if your body is reacting to one situation like constricted, no freedom, no possibilities, then it's obviously not the right decision.
Fair.
And if the other decision makes you feel free and makes you feel happy in the moment, like don't think about the all the other or things that follow.
Things
like,
that might go bad.
Or,
yeah, so those things. So let me tell you an example. When I saw this place, I actually came to pick up a couple of beers from Tonic.
Mm-hmm.
I looked at this place, like I got goosebumps.
Oh, okay.
So when you get that very strong emotion, right? I was driving home and I could just feel the energy, I could feel the vibrations that if I do this, I'll be successful.
Oh, yeah.
So I got that vibration. I don't know how I got it, but it just came naturally to my, like, if I have to do this at any cost.
Yeah, I think, I mean, I already asked you this the first time we met, about how you started it right during Corona, you know?
Yeah.
This is like
F&B
and people are closing shop and you're like, oh, let's just start a cafe here.
See,
so how did your intuition help you get through that?
See, it's very simple. We took this place out during February. That is when Corona was slowly creeping up and I had put my papers also. I was working for this company called Havells. So I was the business development manager handling a couple of products over there. So nobody knew that this is what Corona would be in hindsight, right?
Yeah.
We are sitting on the 1st of February.
In February, we were like planning trips and all.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And the industry was booming.
Mm-hmm.
And we wanted to sign the place, we wanted to do multiple things. So from that perspective, Corona hit March 22nd. My last day in my company was March 31st.
Oh, damn.
We were supposed to open May. We opened in October.
Okay.
So the last 8 months were very difficult. I mean, the amount of hard work that we had gone through, the amount of planning, all went to a toss. Because suddenly you're locked down, you're sitting at home, you're paying rents for a place that you're not using. There is no money that is coming in, only money is going out. But then again, there's this thing that you have to be tough.
Were there times when you thought, oh, maybe this is a bad decision?
Never.
Okay.
Never. Not once did I ever think that this is a bad decision.
Mm-hmm.
I always thought that this decision will make you success, give you success at the right time. You
yeah.
wait for that time.
Mm-hmm.
See, for any businessman, for any first-time business, things are not going to be easy. Things are going to be very tough. So we were prepared in a way after we saw Corona ki life can hit me with anything. I'll still come out of it. Because the restaurant industry, 50% of the restaurants were shut.
Mm.
So only 50% were open. So we saw opportunity in that, right? When things have literally gone down to the shit,
yeah.
You know that the 30% or 40% of restaurants are never going to open up again.
Mm.
So there is that target market, right? There is
yeah.
that market which can be captured.
Yeah, yeah.
So you just have to be patient enough to capture that market. And you should be, see, most of my partners or shareholders in the company are all chartered accountants.
Mm.
So they are good with numbers.
Mm.
So having a finance guy in your team or more than one finance guy in your team will always help you in the long run. to plan things out the straight way, because without the right planning, things will generally end up in a knot. So from that perspective, having the right team has helped us wade through the toughest of times.
Yeah.
So we hit rock bottom.
Yeah.
So from rock bottom, you cannot go any further down. It has to be only one way. That is up. So luckily, that has been our journey so far. We hit rock bottom. From there, we are doing pretty well.
Yeah, yeah.
So there's still much more to be done, of course.
Yeah, I'm excited. Like I wish you would have also like open mic nights, stand-up comedies.
Yeah,
like
we have a lot of those things planned up. Sooner or later, we will sort of get all of the, because see, there are certain teething issues that need to be sorted out with respect to service, with respect to standard operating procedures. So there are multiple things in the restaurant industry that you need to set right before you go and market your product outside. We don't want to, you don't want to sell a half-done product into the market, right?
You've like spoken a lot about your friend circle that you surround yourself with, and I'm very similar to you in that sense. The only reason I started this podcast is I wanted to surround myself with inspiring people, because you don't often get to talk to people outside of your friend circle. I want to, you know, communicate with as many inspiring people as possible to, you know, because you are the sum total of the five people you hang out with.
True, basically. Absolutely.
Yeah. So, how have your friends inspired you into, you know, being the person you are now?
For me, most of my friends have been self-made. We're all from middle class families. We were not born with silver spoons in our mouth.
Mm-hmm.
So we have had to work hard to get where we want. It has not come easy for us.
Yeah.
And for me, the most important thing is to see failure, to experience failure. Because if you're successful in everything that you do, you will never know what failure is, and when you actually fail, you'll not be able to bear it because you've been so successful all your life. So it's very simple. There are a lot of people who study, who are brilliant academics all through their life, but suddenly they come into the work sector or come into the job sector, they start their own businesses, they start seeing failure.
Yeah.
So I have been a bad student. So I was not really great at I sucked at math, but there were a few reasons why I sucked at math, but it is just that if you don't see failure firsthand, if you're not failed a few times in your life early on, it becomes very difficult when you fail later on. So right now, even if everything goes to naught, I can still go to the drawing board, I can start from the scratch. And from that perspective, my friends, you have to have a set of friends who support you in things that you do.
Yeah.
Of course, they have to also tell the negatives that you do.
Yeah.
If you're doing something bad, your friend should come and tell you, okay, this is not the way it's supposed to be. And you should be magnanimous to take that advice.
Exactly. Like, my friends call me out on my bullshit. Like, there was a phase when I came up with ideas left, right and center because I didn't know what I wanted to do. I knew I wanted to do something. I didn't want to do a job. But there were so many ideas in my head, and I kept, you know, throwing ideas at them. And one day my friend came like, Shivani, you need to work on one idea.
True that.
Yeah, she was very straight up. She's like, all these ideas are not going to work. Just focus on one idea.
True.
And go so, from there.
Yeah, so generally, I think a friend who tells you that, it's very important that you respect that.
Yeah.
Because when everybody in this country wants to be an entrepreneur.
Yeah.
Right? Everybody wants to quit their jobs. Everybody wants to start a cafe. Everybody wants to start some food business or whatever business, IT, whatever field that they are in. But one has to have that conviction and the drive to do it.
Yeah.
I put this business up simply because it was floating in my mind since the last 10 years. And it took me 10 years to get where I want to. So patience and time play a very crucial role. You cannot be inexperienced and then put up a business. That's bound to fail. So you have to learn enough to actually know what the business is about. See, I was in sales, I was in business development for the last 5 years. I set up businesses for other companies. We did pretty good business. So from there, when I'm making money for other people, when I'm handling projects, I automatically know the technical know-how of how to run business, how to run a business. Because doing business in India is not easy, man. It's very difficult. It is hyper-competitive.
It's very competitive.
See, you imagine, during Corona, there was a spurt in the sales of pets. A lot of people started buying dogs, a lot of people started buying cats, whatever. So suddenly there was a spurt in all of these pet shops. Now, wherever you go, you see a pet shop. Wherever you go, there's been a pet shop and there are three pet shops beside that. Because people in this country, they cannot think of very new things. So it is that copy-paste mentality. One guy does a good job, everybody has to line up beside him to eat his business only. So when you're looking at so much competition, you have to be really good at what you do. So when the competition is so high, that is also an advantage factor when it comes to you getting better at what you do. So competition, I think, drives me to do better than who I am. So sometimes you should embrace competition. Because that will make you more pumped up to cut that competition and do better than others.
Yeah.
So that is my understanding.
I think also competition makes you consciously grow, and you know, I need to be better than that person. So what can I do differently? So you keep thinking.
True, you're always on your toes.
Yeah.
When you have somebody who's wanting to take away your customer base, you always want to give that much more.
Yeah, what's the little extra that I can?
That extra which makes them come here. So you, once you work towards that, competition is actually a force enabler. It enables you to do things which you would otherwise not do, right? So yeah, that is one thing when it comes to competition. I like it. I like to work under pressure, you know. I like deadlines.
Oh yeah, me too.
You know, it comes, I do things the last minute. But it is under that pressure that makes us, you know, perform our best. We work our output. Procrastinators, exactly. We work much faster and much, our head start thinking much faster when we are under pressure or when there is a deadline. And in sales, there is always a deadline. So, you know, from that perspective, you know, having that kind of a mindset always works.
I was gonna ask you, with your, do you ever feel competition with your friends? I have some pretty successful friends who are doing their own thing, and I would feel a pinch of, oh, they're doing so much, what am I doing? Like, I keep comparing myself. Do you do that, or how do you, because comparison is never great, it doesn't feel great.
See, for me, as a child, nobody, my parents never compared me to anybody else. I have two siblings. Both are super successful. One is a chartered accountant, one is...
They're both elder?
They're both younger, imagine. So, one is a chartered accountant. Being a CA is a very difficult task, passing those exams. So, apart from that, my sister has been in the US. She's a IT technologist, also super successful. But that never, competition... or somebody doing better than you, I never felt that as a lesser, I never thought lesser of me because somebody else is doing better or my friend is doing better. I always took them as inspiration. See, whenever somebody is so successful, there are very specific reasons behind their success. They did not become success overnight, or it did not just come to them for free. Nobody came and handed success over to my friends, at least. So they have had to work hard. So see, no matter how much ever friends you are with the closest of people, you don't go around with them 24/7, right? Probably 2 times a week, 3 times a week, 3-4 hours. So it's a very limited space that you meet your friends. What they do in their private lives, you still do not know completely, no matter how good you are friends with them. So to compare each other's success, it's a very, I feel it's a small-minded approach, small-minded thinking. You should one should go beyond that. One should be more magnanimous to think of the good of that person, the amount of hard work that I've put in, and to take inspiration from them.
Yeah.
So for me, it is always to be inspired by my friends.
Mm.
It is not to feel jealous or feel envy that, oh my God, he's doing so well in life. Why am I not doing? So I might as well see, what should I do to be successful?
Yeah.
Instead of why am I not, I always think, what should I do?
Yeah.
So that is a very important way of looking at things.
Mm.
Okay, what is it that I should do to be as successful as somebody else? So
yeah, like as they say, success leaves trails. So I still sometimes compare,
mm-hmm.
because I don't know, it just comes to me naturally, like, mm. oh, they're doing so well, what am I doing? But then consciously I try to switch that thought to, okay, let's see how they're doing it, like, see what I can learn from this person.
True.
And also I can always talk to my friend, and
true.
You know,
true. See they always, your friends are always some, they give you that good advice, they give you, they inspire you, they cajole you, they convince you to do good things. So it's all up to oneself. See, one, if you don't know who you are, it will be very difficult to be what you want to be.
Yeah.
So you should know what you want. You should be very clear with what you are, what your habits are, what your aspirations are, what your conviction is. So these things are very important to make or break or be who you want to be. So you want to be a wildlife conservationist, right? So
something, I want to do something in the wildlife field.
Okay.
I obviously don't have the degree for wildlife conservationist.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe someday I'll do it.
Fair.
But yeah, I'm thinking of a few ideas.
Mm-hmm. So there are a lot of things in every field in this country to sort of be good at that.
Yeah.
The amount of poaching that is going on, the amount of wildlife destruction that is going on.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of people are needed from that perspective, key, where you're going and reaching that information out to people, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that is, that I think every, see, this is a growing country, man. Imagine in Europe, people only work for 37 hours a week.
Mm-hmm.
Over here, you work for 65 hours a week. So the lesser the economy of a country, the more harder the people work.
Yeah.
That means the more opportunities that are there in a country which is trying to grow.
Yeah.
So for a country like ours, we can do, I mean, the world is open. So I always think that if you are successful in India, you can be pretty much successful anywhere else in the world, because it is very tough to do business here.
Mm-hmm.
It's not so tough in other parts of the world. So from that perspective, I think having the right mindset is very important in anything that you do, or anything that you choose not to do as well. You can sit at home all day, but you should be in the right mindset. You shouldn't feel bad of sitting at home. So, you know, I didn't have a job for a few months. I didn't feel bad. Nobody came and told me, oh, you don't have a job. What are you doing? Why you, you know, why are you wasting your time like this? It's my time to waste. I will waste my time if I want to. I will work if I want to. So you have to be very strong-willed or thick-skinned.
Yeah, yeah.
To be successful. You cannot let everybody's way of thought
opinions,
disturb you,
yeah.
or opinions disturb you.
Mm-hmm.
You have to be very strong-willed in your way of thinking.
What are some values that you think of when finding a partner, people to work with? How do you choose people?
See, it's very simple. You have to choose partners in a way that both of your works do not collide. You don't end up doing the same job.
Huh.
Now, let us say in a company, there is a finance function, there is a marketing function, there is an administrative function, there is a human resource function, there is a technical team. So when you choose partners, you have to choose people from different functions, so that you create that synergy, and that synergy gives you success. You cannot have all the people from a single function and then expect them to work all across.
Yeah, yeah.
So when it comes to good vibes only, all of our partners add value to the company. If somebody is not adding value, then there's no point doing business with them. No matter, even if they get you more money than the other. Because money is not the only criteria, right?
Mm-hmm.
Money is very dispensable. Once it goes, it doesn't come back.
Mm-hmm.
A partner, once he comes, he doesn't go back. So from that perspective, it is very important to choose people who add value to your team, who add value to your company. So if that is taken care of, then there will be less points of friction, less points of both other people's opinion colliding. So mostly it is the thought process collision that makes or breaks a company, right? So for good vibes only, we have a set of partners who are very good at what they do, and what they do does not collide with each other's work.
What's the long-term vision for Good Vibes Only Cafe?
See, pre-corona, if you had asked me of the long-term vision, I could have given you a nice rosy picture.
Yeah.
That we want to be in these many cities by this time. But this pandemic has changed people's view of eating outside, people's view of dining outside. Delivery is a major market today, right? But then again, we would like to wait before we sort of see what our future is. See, it is better to run one thing first properly and then concentrate in the long term about what to do. So ideally, we'd like to have around 6 to 8 cafes in the next 5 years, maybe. So that would be the long term vision for us. Because food business is not an easy business to be in. It's very tough. It takes up a lot of your time. It takes up a lot of your health. It takes up a lot of... You're not able to spend time with your loved ones, right? You don't... I work 14 hours a day. So where do you think I have time to give to anybody else? So from that perspective, you know, we have to first get the first one right. And from there, who knows? You know, because opportunities, when they come calling, we are the kind of guys who will take that opportunity.
Bang the door open.
We'll just bang the door open. So that, we are very aggressive when it comes to that.
Yeah.
And being aggressive in business also helps.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you have to hit numbers, right? I am a sales guy. If I don't have a target dangling on my neck, I tend to sort of procrastinate. So we take targets, we hit those targets. So that is the way at least I'd like to see in the next.
I mean, I'd like to see more of Good Vibes Only Cafe.
Yeah.
Anywhere I travel, I'm like, hey, Good Vibes Only Cafe.
See, that's the name itself is so, you know, interesting.
Yeah.
It has a very general feel to it. Everybody knows Good Vibes. Everybody gets those Good Vibes. So that way, I hope we should be there soon enough.
Yeah.
Soon enough, pretty soon. So.
Cool. I mean, let's hope everything works out 2021. A lot of us are starting new companies, so maybe there's more employment opportunities.
Oh, I think 2021 should be brilliant for everybody.
Yeah.
So that's for sure.
Okay, thank you so much for spending the time with me. I hope this was fun for you.
Thank
it
you so much,
Shivani.
It was amazing talking to you. I could reflect a lot of things that went on in the past 1 year.
Yeah.
By talking to you, sort of getting back all those memories,
yeah.
getting back all of those things, how you did what you did to get where you are.
Mm-hmm.
So that way it has been very interesting.
Yeah, it's always fun to look back and see how far you've come. No?
True,
yeah.
I agree. And I never knew podcast would be so interesting. So,
oh, okay.
You know, this is my first podcast anyways. So,
yeah.
It's been fun. It's been interesting.
Thanks.
Yeah. Thank you.